In this video, I want to talk about five presentation hacks or key features and functionalities in PowerPoint that I think are undervalued, underappreciated by most people that create business presentations. This video doesn't cover all the basics of PowerPoint. I assume you already know how to use PowerPoint and to create somewhat decent presentations, but this will help you to speed up the process and use some cool features that will make your presentations faster, but also better. My name is Felix Haller. I spent years presenting, creating presentations. I spent over 5 years at Bain Company, one of the top management consulting companies. And I want to use this video to share some of my principles, tactics that I teach people that I think give you a little bit of an edge in PowerPoint and creating better presentations. The five topics or hacks I want to talk about are, number one, the quick access toolbar and how you can use shortcuts to quickly use the features and functionalities that you put in there. Number two, how important it is to use an external chart creation plugin instead of using the standard PowerPoint presentation tool. Number three, using the slide sorter to take a step back and looking at your presentation overall and make sure that your presentation story and flow is the most compelling it can be. Number four, how to use Format Painter to apply formatting across your presentations. And then lastly, how to quickly align your boxes to give your presentation and your slides a professional look. You don't have to watch the whole video. Feel free to look at the bottom at the different sections and jump to the section that you are most interested in. I hope this is helpful for you, and let me know any thoughts and questions in the comment section. The first PowerPoint hack I want to talk about is to use the quick access toolbar, which is the little bar here at the top, which you can customize so you have your things up there, the ones you want to use mostly. And the big advantage of using the quick access toolbar is that you can select it with the Alt shortcuts. And this is directly related to shortcuts. A lot of people always want to know what are the shortcuts, the best 50 shortcuts. But the challenge is that if you don't use the shortcuts a lot, you forget them and they're not very useful. I think it's way better to focus on a couple key shortcuts that you actually use a lot for functions that you use a lot. And the Quick Access Toolbar allows you to put a couple key functionalities, 6, 7, 8 functionalities up here that you use a lot, and then you can select them with a Alt number shortcut. So for instance, you can press Alt and then select 1, 2, 3, the numbers, to select the function. And this is super fast, right? It's only 2 clicks. And this is way faster than using the Alt shortcut to select the ribbons. So for instance, you could use the Alt shortcuts to redistribute the columns here by pressing Alt, JL, and then UR, distribute rows. It obviously takes a little longer than doing an Alt and then the numbers. And so the way I've categorized it here at the top or customized it is the first three are all about coloring, which is something I do a lot. Number two is the text color, three is the background color, and then four is borders around boxes and coloring them. So for instance, if I want to quickly change the color here, the text color, I do Alt 2 and then I can do orange or something. Another thing I use a lot is then the backgrounds, changing the background, the cell background, or the background color of a box, Alt 3, and then I can here maybe a light yellow to quickly change it. And this is, like you see, it's pretty fast. And so I think it's extremely useful to use the customized quick access bar, then use Alt numbers to select it. Like I said, I use the first three for the coloring. I use the borders also a lot. So Alt 4, and then I can quickly create a border around something. And you can also change quickly. So if you do Alt 4, then you get into the border section, and then you can press some of the the letters here at the bottom to right away, to quickly change the weight, the thickness of a border, and can play around here. And the same S is the type of border, so you can have like quick dashes. Just to show you how fast you can be if you use the quick access bar and then access it with alt numbers. So the first three are primarily colors. And then the next two I also use a lot is basically changing the font size and the font type. So for instance, if I here want to quickly change the font size and font type, I do Alt 5 and then I type Verdana or Alt 5 Arial. And this is obviously super quick. Arial looks a little better. And then the same goes for the size, Alt 6, and I can just type in 16. 614. This is the first hack that I think is really important to know, and that is way more valuable than remembering weird shortcuts that you use once a week or once a month. Think about what are the things you do a lot in PowerPoint and then move them up into the quick access toolbar and select them by using the Alt and then numbers. I used to have additional ones up here that I used a lot, for instance, the split cell, merge cell, especially when you use tables frequently. I think another one you could have up here is the wrapping or some of the line spacing options that I tend to use a lot. But it really depends on how often you use something. Think about like what are the things you do quite frequently and then put them up here. The second PowerPoint hack I want to share in this video is to use an external chart plugin. The problem with PowerPoint is I love using charts and using charts and data to prove your point, to create compelling charts, I think is crucial. You don't want to just have text-based slides. Charts are just visually more pleasing. They're more compelling as opposed to writing bullet points. And so good presentations have a lot of charts. Unfortunately, the standard way of creating charts in PowerPoint is quite suboptimal. There are a lot of things you can't do with the standard Microsoft PowerPoint chart functions. For instance, calculating automatic growth rates, yearly growth rates, or adding data rows at the bottom of a chart. And also certain chart types you can create. For instance, here on this slide, you see a MECO chart or tree map chart that you can only create with a different type of plugin, or waterfall charts are really hard to create in with the traditional PowerPoint. Typical ones are a ThinkCell. A lot of companies use ThinkCell. Here in this case, I use MECO graphics charts. There are a couple other plugins out there. Unfortunately, most of them are quite pricey. Here, I simply wanna share with you how important, in my opinion, it is to have a better chart creation plugin. But obviously, you might not have a lot of influence over this, whether your company uses one or not. The next PowerPoint hack that I use a lot is using the slide sorter. The slide sorter is here at the bottom. And what it does is it shows all your slides next to each other, and you can actually understand the story of your presentation. I think the problem with the traditional way of creating slides is that you only see one slide at a time. This typically works well if you focus is on only a couple slides, four or five slides, or you split a presentation into different sections and you would only cover one section and really focus on making one slide really, really good. However, in practice, presentations have to flow well. There has to be an overall storyline to achieve the overall objective. A presentation is not just a bunch of slides thrown together and then you just flip through the slides and every slide is totally different. Optimally, you have a story that compels your audience to drive to an action, to get buy-in towards the overall message. A good way to get to that and make sure you have a good story and refine the flow of your presentation is to use the slide sorter. You can click here at the bottom on the slide sorter icon, but you can also click Alt WI. And let me zoom in a little bit more. And the great thing here is it allows you to quickly tell the story and see the overall story. So for instance, in this example, we want to share our point of view about the electric vehicle market. And so we could think of having different sections. So for instance, the first section is the market overview. what's the current adoption of electric vehicles? How do we think this is going to evolve over the next couple of years and decades? Another section, competitive dynamics, who are the different players? How about Tesla? And then lastly, how do consumers feel about the switch to EVs? Would they buy it, etc.? And this is just one example, but here you can quickly see the bird's eye view. Like, what are actually the different sections? How we're going to tell the story? Got rid of all the content on the slide, but I left the action titles, the slide headers. And that's how I would highly recommend you to think of your story. What are the slide headers, the slide titles that tell your story? And does it make sense? And so here we would start with, the EV market has increased significantly. However, it's still small compared to other regions. And these four factors will drive the adoption going forward. I think this is a good flow, but then here you could think about, does it make sense to share, to move this slide before the other one? Should we first talk about the factors that drive adoption, and then what is it currently, or like what's it been historically, and then the forecast? That's a huge advantage of using this bird's eye view, is that you can step back, not care so much about the content on the slide, but what the slide says and stands for and how that fits into the overall flow. And then you could go on the next section, how are we going to tell the story about the competitive dynamics, who are the players, what are the changes, who is winning, who is losing, and then lastly, end with the customer feedback. And without going here into the details of this particular story, I want you to take away that it's extremely powerful to step back at times and look at the presentation story from out here and make sure that the sequence of your slides works well and that you have the right slides in your story to achieve your objective. And the goal of your presentation should be to achieve the specific objectives of the presentation, not that one specific slide is the best slide ever. If you spend a lot of time on one slide making it great, but it doesn't fit into the story, then you wasted a lot of time. The next PowerPoint hack is to use the Format Painter function. It's a function Microsoft has across their platforms. You can also use it in Microsoft Word and in Excel. But I think in PowerPoint, it's the most effective because you tend to have a lot of different styles and formatting in presentations. Some people like dark backgrounds, some like light backgrounds with dark colors, colored texts. Some have dash borders. And some have solid ones. And you want your presentations to look very clean and consistent. You use consistent formatting. And the Format Painter functionality up here allows you to quickly use one format and apply it to another box or slide element. So for instance, if I like this formatting here, I could click Format Painter and paste it on here, and then it would instantly take over all the formatting. And while you can click once to paste it one time, to apply it one time, but what's also really powerful is you can double click the Format Painter, and then you can apply it multiple times on multiple boxes. So click, click, and so you have instantly the same format on the other box. You can not only do that with boxes, you can obviously also do it with bullet points and a lot of other things or slide elements. So for instance, for the text, this one is a little darker. So now we have the black one. Also, the distance between the bullet points, etc., and the type of bullet points. For that, it's really helpful. And you can also do that across slides. So sometimes you might have different formatted bullet points across your presentation. So you can quickly do that and make sure that all your bullet points are formatted the same way, all your boxes are formatted the same way, etc. So really, really powerful. The last PowerPoint hack I want to talk about is to align boxes. You don't want to go crazy. It's not the purpose to have every box perfectly aligned and nothing jumping across slides. You probably won't get paid for creating slides unless you are a management consultant or in a consulting industry where it's really important that your slides look super crisp and clean. You might want to spend extra time on it, but I think even in a normal business setting, you want to make sure that the boxes are fairly aligned and things look overall clean. And for instance, in this example, the boxes here are positioned a little weirdly. doesn't make sense that they have like that they are not all aligned, and so you want to quickly align them here on the left hand side, and also make sure that things at the top are aligned, and just so it all overall looks clean. And what you can do quickly here is you select all the boxes, and then there is this icon arrange, align, and here you can do a lot of things. And I think the most common, or the ones you will probably use a lot, are the align one, align left, right, top, and bottom. And then there are a couple other more interesting ones, the align center and align middle, and we're gonna also use that in a second. But I would say as a start, I'm gonna just use the align left here. And you see it's all aligned to the left, looks really, really clean. Another function I like to use some at times is the align in the middle. So you see it, or center here. So then it centers all the elements. So in this situation, we probably wanna have all the boxes the same size. So what I typically do is just select them all the same size. And then you can play around with the align functionality. So I would say align left first, and maybe select the executive summary here at the top. So then it aligns all of these elements to the left. And then another powerful function is to distribute them vertically. So then the spaces between them are the same. Yeah, I would probably just quickly make this a little cleaner here. And you can also add additional elements. So for instance, these dividers here aren't perfectly centered. And so what we can do is select all of it and then do distribute vertically. And so then even the spaces in between here are exactly the same. And this looks really clean now, right? I mean, I guess maybe here this at the top, it's a little narrow. This one I would probably just manually quickly adjust it. So that looks really clean. And so even by just quickly doing a little bit of aligning, your slide will look significantly better. But like I said, you don't have to go overboard. I hope you enjoyed this video. We talked about 5 specific presentation hacks that I think you can use in PowerPoint to improve your presentation creation process, but also will lead to better presentations. If you have any thoughts, comments, additional tactics that you love to share with others and that you want me to cover more, please let me know in the comment section, and I hope to see you in the next video.